The following is a special presentation of the Simulation Football League.
And Garcia will drop the pass, and Garcia fires deep down the middle. Wide open! That's Stockwell, and that's a touchdown, Queen City! Dazzo back to pass. Dazzo over the middle. That pass is completed. Pushing his way into the end zone is Elijah Bishop. Touchdown, Baltimore. Coleman hands it off to Black. Black breaks a tackle. Black with a stiff arm. There he goes! Black, you gotta be kidding me! 72 yards! Touchdown, Houston!
It's the SFL live on Twitch TV.
Welcome to Spradling International Field. It's Sunday Night Football on the SFL Network. And we hope your football fix is not over. Bobby Long, the Carolina Skyhawks take on Juan Bosco and the Santa Fe Gorillas in week two here in the Simulation Football League. Hello, everybody. I'm your play-by-play commentator, Kevin Irvine. And if you notice, Santa Fe's wearing orange alternates tonight for their home opener. Skyhawks and Gorillas. As Santa Fe looks for their first win of the season, and the Skyhawks try to go 2-0. Let's head down to the field for the coin toss.
How you doing? You ready to go?
Gentlemen, please make your call.
We'll take heads.
Heads it is.
We want the ball.
The Demons have won the toss and select to receive.
The Carolina Skyhawks will get the football to start the game tonight. Santa Fe's kicker, Zeke Klein, has it on the tee, approaches the football, kick it! From the two, Carolina on the return. Past the 20 to the 21-yard line. Skyhawks in their all-white roads with the blue helmets, blue jerseys, red and blue trim. Santa Fe in blue helmets, orange jerseys, blue pants, white numbers, orange and white trim. As we just get things started here on the SFL Network. The quarterback for Carolina is Jamison Monroe, the rookie, 6'2", 190. And he starts with an empty backfield tonight against Santa Fe's tenacious secondary, and Monroe will drop to throw. Throws left side, and Montero nearly picked it off. Christoph Montero comes flying in out of nowhere and forces a second down and 10, and a good start for the Santa Fe defense. They gave up 23 points last week in a 23-9 loss to Oklahoma City.
Second and 10.
Second down and 10. There's a look at Frank Flores. He is the new leader of this defense, had seven tackles and a tackle for loss last week. Empty backfield for Monroe for the second consecutive play on second down and 10. Back to pass, Monroe fires left side, that's complete for a 6-yard pickup. And it'll be third down and 4 for Carolina. Carolina got started with a 27-24 victory over Orlando on a game-winning field goal. What a way to start a new franchise. And of course, the North Carolina's got another pretty good football team as well. Third down and 4 here for the Skyhawks. And the handoff goes up the middle to Johnny English, and he got the first down. So in 3 plays, Carolina able to move the sticks and keep their defense off the field. English had a phenomenal week 1, 233 yards on 29 carries. Thursday night, not a single running back gained over 200 yards. English had 3 touchdowns in that victory. All of Carolina's touchdowns. I formation here on first and 10 from the 32. Out of the eye, the handoff goes to English on a counter from Monroe. English tried to get break outside, picks up two. Second down and eight. And Kyle Walsh has a game break for us from NYC. What's going on out there in the nation's largest city?
Home sweet home. Sailors opening up their homestead against the Vipers and scored the first 5 minutes. What a pretty catch. It's Peter's first passing touchdown this season. NYC up 7-0. Back to you, Cam.
Second and eight from the Demons. Sailors off to a fast start, but the Vipers have quickly closed. That game's now knotted up at seven. Second down and eight, Monroe. Has time, looks deep in double coverage. Oh, it's caught on the right sideline! And the big fella down the sideline of the 17-yard line. That's Shan Varner, the rookie, and it's first down for Carolina in the red zone. What a catch by Varner in double coverage here. Montero through traffic, and Varner pulled it in with one hand and nearly scored a touchdown. We have seen some phenomenal play out of the tight ends around the league through the first couple of weeks, and there may have not been a better touchdown catch from a tight end than that one. And a big throw from Monroe, first and 10 at the 17. And the handoff to Johnny English, and he gets to the 11-yard line, picks up six. The Skyhawks down just near the 10-yard line. The Santa Fe defense, T.L. Alvarado at linebacker, number 17. Cornerback Frank Flores and Joe Lynn, 28 and 26 respectively. Free safety Christoph Montero. Handoff goes to English, and he's dropped for a loss. Carlo Montero, the twin, is at strong safety. Rounding out the Santa Fe defense, Alvarado on that tackle there. For the Carolina offense, Yuya Iba, Caesar Cannon, 13 and 87 respectively at wide receiver. Shan Varner, we've already met him, number 88 at tight end. Quarterback is Jamison Monroe, number 9, and the running back is Johnny English, number 24. Back to pass, Monroe caught, first down again. Another third down conversion for Carolina, their second on the drive. That's Iba on the catch. Alvarado on a second straight tackle, and it's first and goal with the 5.
First and goal from Carolina.
First and goal in an impressive beginning for the Carolina Skyhawks here on the road. Split backs with Monroe. Handoff and a big hit in the backfield. A 2-yard loss. That's a big boy. Number 94 coming in there and cleaning up. English taking a seat on the bench. Perez on the tackle. Second and goal now for the Skyhawks. Happy to have you along for the ride tonight here on the SFL Network. Another exciting night as week 2 hits the midway point here in the Simulation Football League. Out of the eye, Monroe's had a good drive. Handoff, English, left side. English trying to stretch it out. Stiff arm, Johnny English, touchdown with authority. And English has his fourth rushing touchdown of the season, of the young season. And Carolina goes 4 minutes and 3 seconds on the opening possession and gets on the board. 7:57, Hooper. You must have made that, the name doesn't sound familiar. You must have made the player after we got the season started, after our drafts. But you'll be eligible for the draft this offseason coming up here late in the spring. So stay tuned and stay with us and have some fun while your player waits to gain entry into the league. Carolina off to a fantastic start. The extra point is good, and it's Carolina 7, Santa Fe nothing. Just an outstanding start for Carolina. And Santa Fe, who's known for their defense and who's struggled in week one. Already down 7-0 here in their home opener. That was a statement drive there by the Skyhawks. On the return, Santa Fe put down at about the 28-yard line. Coming up on Monday, the DC Dragons and the Minneapolis Maulers in the SFL Game of the Week, along with Orlando and Houston. Cedric Trevilian, Koma Kaleka, and the whole gang doing battle. That's tomorrow, 7 p.m. Central, here on the SFL Network. First and 10 at the 28-yard line. First possession of the night for Matt Wilson, and he flips it out to Isaac Montoya, and he's put down. That's a 1-yard loss. June Fierro on the stop. Santa Fe was Mr. Checkdown last week, and they hope to bring some more explosivity to the offense tonight, but that's going to be hard. Carolina's defense, pretty good. June Fierro at corner, along with Maurice Spurgeon, the rookie. Linebackers Gage Wilson, Jeb Gatlin, and Bobby Law. Law had 2 sacks last week. Second down and 11. Wilson back to pass against a blitz. Fires right side. Pass complete for an 8-yard pickup. That's Ulysses Mora. Billy Joe Gatlin on the tackle. He's at strong safety. And Julius O'Neill is at free safety for Carolina. Mora had a good week in the loss. 7 catches, 58 yards, but failed to reach the end zone. They'd like to get him as involved as possible tonight. Down and 3, Montoya straight up the middle. That's a first down, Santa Fe. 757 Hooper, simulationfl.com. Go to community and or hover your mouse over community on the site's menu and you'll see message board.
First and 10 from 39.
Someone give that man a link. First and 10, good start for both offenses here tonight. Wilson goes under center with Montoya in the backfield. Ball on the 39-yard line, 5:20 to go in the first quarter. Carolina has built an early 7-0 lead. Wilson's in some trouble, and Wilson is sacked. Carolina got off after Connor Pyatt in last week's victory, and Matt Wilson goes down here. And it'll bring up second down and 12.
Second and 11 from 37 yards.
Two receivers, that's Bosco and Nick T. Quick, and Wilson faces a heavy blitz, and the pass is nearly intercepted. Knocked away by Spurgeon. Spurgeon had a fine game to start his career. Had 3 tackles, but really was good in defending the pass and defending Lorenzo Allen. He really shut down their top target. Juan Bosco is the top target of this offense. Nick T. Quick, Ulysses Mora follow suit, and the second tight end, Chris Bush, they like to get involved when they can. Split receivers, 7 in the box for Carolina, and a 3-4 look. Back to pass, Wilson, and Wilson fires it short, pass is complete, Law, and Jeb Gatlin combine on the stop, it's 4th down. And I don't think Wilson knew that Santa Fe was in a 3rd down situation there. Threw it well short of the sticks. Mora's got a couple early grabs, but Carolina's defense on the road gets a stop. The Skyhawks get a touchdown and force a punt here in the early going. An impressive showing out of the Skyhawks here so far on the return to the 23-yard line with 4:14 to go in the first. Queen City Sioux Falls and Cleveland NYC going on around the host of networks. The only place where you can watch all 3 games, simulationfl.com. Go to the game day page and get your football fix. We've got more games in the next hour and 45 minutes than the NFL had all day. First and 10 at the 23. Split backs, Monroe is under center. 5 down lineman for Santa Fe, and Johnny English is smashed. A 3-yard loss back to the 20. Frank Flores in on the coverage. Flores at corner, 7 tackles and a tackle for loss last week. That's pretty good for a corner.
Second and 12.
Getting gritty in the trenches. Three in the backfield now for Carolina on a second down and 13. And the draw, Johnny English, and he makes one man look silly, finally wrestled down. Got back to the original line of scrimmage, will be third and 10 at the 23. Johnny English, a phenomenal player. He's a six-year vet. A lot of six-year vets on this Carolina team. Cesar Cannon, Yuya Iba, Johnny English, the Gatlin brothers. And Gage Wilson came out of retirement, but that's still a lot of six-year vets there for the Skyhawks. Check down here from Monroe, and that'll be a three and out for the Skyhawks. Good defense there by Santa Fe. Not letting anything get behind him. Iba on the catch, his second of the night, and Carolina will punt it away. Florida Raiders 77 asks if Carolina is the oldest team in the league. I'm not quite sure. That would be interesting to figure out, though. Carolina's up there, though, as Santa Fe returns up to the 41-yard line. 2:41 to go in the opening quarter. The lone score so far, a Johnny English touchdown, his fourth of the year. For Carolina, their passing game off to a good start as well. Just 162 yards last week. They only attempted 18 passes. Monroe a bit more active here. Bosco does not have a catch, neither does Quick here in the early going. Back to pass, Wilson. Wilson's got a good pocket, fires out to Bosco. That pass is complete, an 8-yard pickup. Nicely done by Juan Bosco. Good route to the outside. Brings up second and two at the 49. Spurgeon going to give Bosco that all day. Does not want to get beat deep. Maurice Spurgeon, one of the top picks in the SFL rookie draft. 5'10", 200. Second and two at the 49. Wilson, straight back, fires down the middle, nearly threw an interception. That was Spurgeon again, and we are saying his name a lot here in the early going. The storyline of the night, the two owners and their differences. Santa Fe's Joel Ramos-Lynn, a high school student, but put the SFL on blast when he made the SFL championship game last year, losing narrowly to DC 31-30. Carolina high school football coach, the team's owned by James Klein. So we'll see who the master is tonight. Third down and two at the 49-yard line. Wilson calling out signals. Hand off Montoya. Oh, Montoya gets crushed. That was Jeb Gatlin, who with a force holds Santa Fe to a fourth down. An impressive play there by Jeb Gatlin, who was a little quiet in the win over Orlando. Just six tackles. Santa Fe's offense stays on the field. Fourth and inches at the 49. Santa Fe approaching five quarters to start the season without a touchdown. They're going to go for it. Wilson flips it out. Check down. And he did not get it. And Carolina takes over on downs. Bobby Law and Jeb Gatlin combined for the stop as Montoya cannot gain an inch. A good play call, but the Skyhawks swarm to the football. And with 1:40 to go in the first quarter, Carolina takes over with excellent field position. Ball at the 49, Carolina. An impressive showing here to start. Out of the eye, tight set for Monroe. And Monroe hands it off to English. And English bounces off a tackler and picks up three. Santa Fe doing a good job of containing Johnny English. Just 22 yards on eight carries here in the early going as Lee helps him up. Second and seven to the 48. Empty's backfield again here from Monroe. And Monroe throws it short. It's picked off. Interception by Carlo Montero. And it's first down Santa Fe. The Gorillas did not force a turnover last week. And in a crowd looking for Shan Varner, Carlo Montero made sure that He was not duped by Varner again. And after Carolina's stop, the Skyhawk offense gives it right back. That's Monroe's first interception of the season. Wilson's out of the shotgun with two receivers. Bosco in quick to the right side. 109 to go in the first quarter. Carolina 7. Santa Fe nothing here on the Sunday Spotlight game on the SFL Network. Back to pass. Wilson fires down the middle into triple coverage. That pass is complete. Mora doing his thing. Check this out. What a bullet from Matt Wilson. I don't know how that pass is complete. In between Fierro, Spurgeon, and Gatlin All-Stars. First and 10 at the 34. Best pass of the night for Wilson. Wilson out of the gun. Low snap. Back to pass. The lefty throws it short. 3-yard pickup. That is Bosco's second catch of the night. Wilson on the tackle. Gage Wilson coming out of retirement after he was out of the league for more than a year. 6'3", 235. Formerly played in the WAFL for the Chicago Ghosts, St. Louis Hornets, and may have traveled to one more team, but I know he was in Chicago with Logan Foster and with the Hornets and Daly Holder. Second down and 7 from the 31. Hand off to Montoya. Picks up a block. Nice run. Fierro on the tackle. Brings up third down and inches. Montoya 13 yards rushing, but a better average than Johnny English as we end the first quarter. Carolina 7, Santa Fe nothing. This is the SFL Network. Third down and short. Santa Fe unable to convert a fourth and short in the first quarter. Wilson and company try to pick it up. Oh, Carolina jumped offside. That's going to give them a first down.
Neutral zone infraction. Number 75. Defense.
Crucial mistake. On the Skyhawks, moves the ball to the 19-yard line. Gibbs was the one that moved. He had the sack earlier in the game. And the loss for Montoya is wiped away. First and 10 of the 19-yard line. Santa Fe's best drive of the night so far. Looking for their first touchdown of season 6. Hand off to Montoya, and Montoya picks up 3. Second and 7 at the 16-yard line. Good start here for Montoya. Wilson on the tackle. Carolina's defense, pretty impressive. Got a lot of stars out there. One of the few teams that has 7 stars on the defense. They're going to be a hassle to deal with all season long, I would imagine. Second and 7 at the 16. Wilson straight back, swings it out. Montoya, and he's wrapped up. And Wilson's got to stop. Putting it to Montoya. Spurgeon on the tackle. Against any other team, it might work out. But Carolina very stout on the sides in the secondary.
Third and
got a lot of linebackers out there as well to get outside. Coached by Andy Hamilton. They're off to a good start. Third down and 7. Santa Fe trying to convert. They need the 9.5-yard line. Wilson, 5-step drop. Goes to the end zone, and the pass is knocked away by Spurgeon. Looking for Bosco. The pass is incomplete. And what a first half for Maurice Spurgeon. You see Carolina had everyone locked up, and Wilson took a shot. Bush, well defended by Law. Nothing there either, and Spurgeon just got a hand in there. So fourth down and 7. Santa Fe will come on to attempt a 34-yard field goal. Zeke Klein was 3-for-3 in his first game in a gorilla uniform. From the left hash for the right-footed kicker. And the field goal for Santa Fe is good. Santa Fe is still held out of the end zone. but they cut the deficit to 4, 7-3. Line nicely done, right through the middle. For daily updates of the Simulation Football League and everything that surrounds it, visit SimulationFL.com for your daily dose of league updates, blogs, message boards, stats, everything you can imagine. The Hype Southerner interview in week two is with the defending champion, Jermaine Smith. He plays the Maulers tomorrow night, and an interview with him and the Hype Southerner will be up tomorrow on the website. 9:15 to go in the first half. Carolina has built a 7-3 advantage. Has looked sharp doing it, although Monroe did throw an interception on his last drive to Carlo Montero. Skyhawks start this possession with a 26. Back to pass, Monroe. Dangerous ball, incomplete. Monroe's got to be careful. Soto on the coverage. But not a good look there from Jamison Monroe. Oh, and the podcast too. And you guys, we didn't get a chance to get it up in time, but Ronnie Nickens did an excellent job bringing back the SFL Insider. We've got Hamilton's podcast as well. And forgive me, the name escapes me. But all that stuff will be up. We'll be working on that section of the website actually tonight. As Monroe goes deep and Cannon dropped the pass. Cannon was open and Monroe put it on the money. And Caesar Cannon can't believe it. Cannon now top of the screen, defended by Flores. Empty backfield here on third down and 10. Carolina's really not gotten Johnny English much involved in this game. And a short throw will be well short of the first down. And Carolina will have to punt again. Monroe up to 70 yards. But just unable to get Johnny English much involved. And that's a little surprising considering Pete Bruschi's solid day against the Gorillas in week one. And the Gorillas known more for their secondary than stopping the run. So Skyhawks looking away from Johnny English here in the early going. Interesting. Fourth down, they punt it away. And the Gorillas from the 29-yard line put down at the 32, 8:29 to go in the first half. Coming up next week, Queen City at Cleveland is what starts week three along with Carolina, Oklahoma City. Only two games next Thursday, three on Monday. Sunday, it's a 12 Central time right before the NFL Championship Game doubleheader. Baltimore, Sioux Falls, Houston, Santa Fe, San Francisco, D.C. Coming up later in the week on the SFL Network. First and 10 at the 32. Wilson starts the drive off with an incompletion. Hit the receiver right in the hands. That was Nick T. Quick, who doesn't drop much at second and 10.
Let's go.
Both these teams trying to figure out where the upper hand is early on. Wilson has looked a little bit more like he's okay with going downfield, but still not able to test very much the Carolina secondary. And Montoya is wrapped up by Spurgeon and Law. Everywhere you look for the Skyhawk team, someone is flying in to make a tackle. That's a loss of one, and it's third and long for Santa Fe. Both offenses struggling here in the second quarter.
Third and 11.
Third and long, Matt Wilson, deep shot right side, caught! First down of the 49, Juan Bosco. Wrestled down by Billy Joe Gatlin, it's his third catch on six targets and a Gorilla first down. Matt Wilson starting to get the rhythm. Two receivers left side. 3-4 look from the Skyhawk defense. Montoya in the backfield. Wilson back to pass. Wilson throws short. That's Bosco's fourth grab. Out of bounds and says hello to Frank Flores. It's 2nd and 6, a gain of 4. It's a beautiful night for football here in Mexico City. 70 degrees and just pretty skies out there. Back to pass, Wilson. Deep drop back, Wilson gets it away just in time. Nice tackle in the open field by Spurgeon. Bosco made the catch. Surprise, they gave him 4 yards on the reception. Matt Wilson doing a good job of getting rid of the ball before that Carolina pressure gets there. He's already been sacked once in this game, but the pocket was closing around him, and he put a dart out there to Bosco, who now has a handful of grabs. 3rd down and 2. Back to pass. Deep shot. Wilson down the middle. Overshot Juan Bosco. And it's 4th down. Wilson goes for the jugular. With 6:37 to go in the first half, and Santa Fe's drive stalls out, they'll have to punt it away, and Carolina continues to maintain their lead. Scored a touchdown on the opening possession. Punter comes out now for Santa Fe to try to pin the Skyhawks deep. Inside the 10, down to the 4. Look at the bounce. Stay out of the end zone. Oh, geez. That's a not top 10 right there. Carolina gets it on the 20. Had the punt stopped. Just didn't know where the goal line was. Coming up, SFL at the half. Halftime update. We'll have highlights from all the Thursday games in case you missed it or just want to relive the night all over again. And we'll have first half analysis of Carolina and Santa Fe. It's the SFL update, halftime report. And it's coming your way in a bit here on SFLN1 as Johnny English picks up just 1 yard. Santa Fe's run defense much better this week. Flores on the stop. Along with Powers. Monroe's got a pick. Montero was the man to take it away from Carolina early on. English takes a handoff, hit in the backfield, and put down in the backfield. Just 2.3 yards per carry for Johnny English. A nice first half for Santa Fe's defense, which also played pretty well against Oklahoma City in the first half last week. Empty backfield on 3rd and 9 for Carolina. Cannon missed a big pass early on in this quarter. Underneath, Santa Fe will take that all day. Iba with the catch, but both teams struggling with the deep ball, and Carolina will have to punt it away. A very defensive first half. But Carolina really has been impressive, holding their own against the runner-up from last year. A interesting stat that we discovered before the game, and Santa Fe will start the drive from the 37-yard line. In every SFL season, a team that qualified for the playoffs the previous season went 0-2 to start next season. New York actually did it in back-to-back years following their championships. A couple other teams did as well. The Dallas Stars did 1 year. The Orlando Intimidators did the next, actually last season. And Santa Fe is the only team that qualified for last year's playoffs that has not won a game so far. 1st and 10, back to pass. Wilson fires it right side, caught. 1st down to the Carolina 43-yard line. That's Nick T. Quick, and finally Quick gets involved. Santa Fe's had a much better half in the passing department, or much better quarter, I should say, with Gatlin on the tackle, but just have not been able to produce the points.
1st and 10 from the Demons, 43 yards.
I'm checking Carolina.
Wilson under center. Back to pass. Wilson's got time. Flips it out short. Montoya's out of bounds. Montoya doing nothing in the passing game. Loss of one. Fourth or second. Pardon, and 11. I believe fourth grab for Montoya. Oh, that's true. True shot. That's true. Very good point. Yeah, so that could happen to the Dragons as well. But every season, a team that made the playoffs the previous year has started 0-2. And we're wondering if Santa Fe and Dallas are going to continue that trend. Second down 11 for Gorilla fans. They sure hope not, as Montoya makes the catch. But again, no gain. And Wilson and Montoya must have some sort of bonus involved, depending upon the receptions of Montoya, because Wilson has been good when he's looked down the field, but too often still a bit passive. Third down and 11. Another third long situation for Santa Fe. Wilson, right side, knocked away. June Fierro on the coverage. Fierro, a good opener. Nine tackles, had an interception as well. Carolina's lone pick from a star in week one. And on fourth down, Santa Fe will have to punt again. Snap a little to the left of Santa Fe's punter. Puts it inside the 10. Santa Fe will try again to hold them out of the end zone, and they do it this time. Ball takes a hop and a little bounce backwards to the 7. And Carolina's got a long field with 3:35 to go in the first half. 7-3. Carolina on top. Toronto improved to 2-0. They would be the first team in the Gray Conference to get to 2-0, as they're the only two teams from the Gray playing tonight. Flags on the play.
Encroachment, number 26, defense, yard penalty.
Wow, you don't see a lot of encroachments. That's Joe Lynn, beg your pardon. So a rare encroachment call makes it 2nd and 5 from the 12.
Great.
First and 5 from the Demons.
Monroe's rating continues to steadily dip as he is unable to find anyone deep down the field. Split backs. Monroe is under center. Both defenses playing a phenomenal first half. English takes the carry and he lost 2 yards. There is just no room for English. Alvarado on the tackle. Alvarado led the team in tackles last week with 9. He was a very subtle piece in Santa Fe's defense last year, but is proving to be a bigger threat. And Johnny English got out of the backfield. Oh, big stiff arm. And then Montero puts him down at the 22, but a first down. Back gain about 12 for Johnny. Watch this run. Johnny hurdles, sidesteps, stiff arms, and is finally tackled by Montero. Alvarado was the unfortunate recipient of the stiff arm. Three receivers, check that. 2 to the right side for Monroe. Monroe back to pass, and that's complete in between the zone coverage. Caesar Cannon on the catch, 2nd and 1 as the clock ticks down. As we approach the 2-minute warning, both teams on 3 timeouts. Skyhawks lead 7-3 on a Johnny English touchdown. High formation here as they'll likely try to just push it forward for a first. And they do. English. Oh, English whacked in the backfield. Run defense exceptional here in the first half for Santa Fe as we've hit the 2-minute warning. Carolina up 7-3. Halftime report coming up next. Highlights from Thursday's action. An analysis of Carolina and Santa Fe's defensive first half.
Let's go.
Stay tuned for that. Spradling International Field. Rising to the smokestacks. 3rd and 2. Two receivers left side. Monroe in an empty set. Back to pass, Monroe. Monroe, sidearm throw. It's dropped by Cannon. Cannon comes out of nowhere. What a throw from Monroe to just stick it right into his hands. But Cannon cannot hold on to it as he comes to the ground, and Carolina has to punt. Punt is away from the Skyhawks. From the 30, Santa Fe's had pretty good field position all night. They'll start from the 34-yard line, all three timeouts in their pocket. Santa Fe has gone nearly six quarters to start the season without a touchdown. And the Skyhawks in six quarters have given up just 27 points defensively. 1st and 10 at the 34. Wilson under center. Seven in the box for Carolina. And Wilson will drop the throw. Wilson down the middle, knocked away. Brings up 2nd down and 10, 1:44 on the clock.
Second and 10, ball at the 34-yard line.
Hand off Montoya, left side. And only got one. Carolina going to hold on to the timeouts. Julius O'Neill on the stop. Quiet night for O'Neill, the member of the Tallahassee Pride last year. And he'll see his old team twice as they both play in the same division. Wilson out of the shotgun, looking to convert on 3rd down, nearly hit, and Mora takes a shot well before the sticks from Bobby Law. Carolina applying the pressure, and it forced Wilson to get the ball out of his hands early as we just continue to go back and forth in a very lethargic second quarter for both of these offenses. Carolina still with the upper hand. Santa Fe to punt it away. Carolina doesn't burn a timeout. They still have all three left in their pocket, but I don't think either team trusts their offense enough to be taking chances and stopping the clock here in this first half. And we'll see what Carolina does with 23 seconds from their own 26-yard line. Monroe with split backs in the backfield will give it off to English, and English breaks a tackle. He's in the open field. Johnny English past the 50, past the 40, and Lynn closes on him, and Carolina takes a timeout with 15 seconds left. The longest play from scrimmage tonight is Johnny English found some green. Lynn able to stop him from scoring, but Carolina at the 30 in position to score just before the half. And they bring on the field goal team. Points are valuable. Carolina not taking any chances. They want to go up by 7 heading into the half. This is a 46-yard kick. And from the left hash, the 46-yard kick, he missed it. Oh, my gosh. Jamie Hart, who hit the game winner last week against Orlando, misses the field goal. And because Carolina elected to take the point so early, Santa Fe now has 10 seconds left in the first half and three timeouts to do something with it. Four wide receivers for Wilson. They can get into Hail Mary range. Give Wilson a shot to pull a Rodgers. Nope, they hand it off to Montoya. He gets up the middle of the field to 41. And they'll burn a timeout and now bring on the chuck it to the end zone formation. What a defensive first half. Carolina has got to be proud that for two more quarters, they once again have held the Gorillas out of the end zone and on their home field. Santa Fe, like DC, like Tallahassee, did not lose a home game last year. Bosco, five catches, but on just nine targets. So Matt Wilson looking to take advantage. Back to, oh, unblocked! Wilson sheds the block, and then he's put down for the sack. And if that was Bobby Law, that's his third of the season. Carolina came in unblocked for much of that play, and we've hit the first half. The first half's end. Carolina 7, Santa Fe 3. SFL Halftime Report is next. Oklahoma City, Dallas, the game of the night, no doubt. Middle of the second quarter, a red feather pass is dropped and into the hands of Dallas. It's the Law's second pick six in as many weeks, and the Law took a 14-0 lead, but Oklahoma City would fight back, down 24-13, fast forward to the fourth. Red feather, Johnny Bierme, beautiful pass to the back shoulder of Bierme. So the Renegades right back in it, they're only down four. Well, they forgot that Dallas can score in every way possible. From the 2-yard line, they call him Youngblood, and he makes two people miss, and the Law shut the door on Oklahoma City's comeback. They go up 31-20 on the 98-yard scamper, but Oklahoma City says not so fast. Down just eight, they've got the ball back. Red Feather's out of the shotgun. He's looking deep to Tiberius Bovine, who makes the catch. But on the play, Red Feather is hurt, and Oklahoma City was called for clipping. It would back the Renegades all the way up to a first and 29 and really be the devastating factor. Oklahoma City recovered an onside kick just to get the ball back. A couple of plays before this happened, and you see Red Feather gets hit low and twirled around. Backup comes in, very next play for OKC, Gavin Hawk. Picks them off, 31-23, Dallas wins. Tallahassee, Louisville, I don't know what happened to the Pride tonight, but they sure didn't play with any. Lester Grimes picks off Alexander West in the end zone in the beginning of the second quarter, and then on the very next play, Overstreet says, hey, remember me? I'm still an elite back. Bye-bye, Tallahassee, all the way to the end zone. There it is, 14-0 Wolfpack. And they were just getting started. Watch this. Shovel pass. Whoop! Right up the middle. And oh, what a move by Overstreet. Sick! And he goes untouched again. Pulling a Darnell Black. 21-3 Louisville. Still early in the second quarter. It's 24-6 now. Early in the third. Alexander West. This is all he did tonight. Another bad pass. Lucius Sanders picks it off, his second of the season. Louisville goes the other way, all the way up to midfield. Up 18, and they would increase that lead later on in the third quarter. Skeletor P. Funk, he ate right tonight, finds rookie D.D. Ritter. That's a touchdown and a perfect pass. Louisville ends up winning 37-16. San Francisco, Baltimore from beautiful Wayland Corporate Field. We don't get to show you kickoffs often. Haven't even gotten our popcorn and soda yet in this one, just kicking off, and San Francisco says, hey, better pay attention to us, because we're going to the end zone, breaking a tackle at the 43-yard line, and see you later. Baltimore crabs. No one's going to catch them. Who needs a star back there to return kicks? San Francisco could do it without one. 7-0 early on. 17-14. Bulldogs playing a pretty good first half on the road. Dwayne Drew escapes pressure from Joe Dazzo momentarily, but then Dazzo tackles him, and there Drew lays. A back injury late in the first half. He would not return. It would get a whole lot worse for San Francisco. 8 seconds to go in the second quarter. We're tied at 17. Baltimore's just going to run out the clock, right? Right? Elliott Snyder doesn't know what that means. Breaks a tackle at midfield, and he goes the distance. And just like that, Baltimore takes a 24-17 advantage. Heading into the second half, things would continue to snowball for San Francisco. Baltimore would go on and score a ridiculous amount of points in a row. This long pass to Houdet out that makes it a rout. Baltimore wins 45-24. It's halftime from Mexico. Carolina leads 7-3. Here are your halftime numbers. The Skyhawks balance 75 on the ground, 84 through the air, 159 total. Both teams converted on just 2 third downs. Carolina 2 for 6, Santa Fe 2 for 8. The one turnover in this game, interception by Carlo Montero from the hands of Jamison Monroe. 10-16 to 11-03 in time of possession. That's pretty even there. Johnny English, 14 carries, 78 yards and a touchdown, mostly on that long run to end the half that ended up not getting any points. Christoph Montero, 6 tackles and 1 pass defended. The Gorillas, 92 passing yards, 21 rushing yards, just 113 in total offense. Both teams have just 5 first downs.
Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and make sure never to miss a moment of the action by following our channel on Twitch. This has been SFL Halftime Update. Enjoy the second half.
Start of the second half from Mexico. Carolina kicks it off. Santa Fe will get the ball to start the second half. And a big hit starts it for Carolina's special teams. The Skyhawks up 7-3. And the returner, Doring Lopez, for Santa Fe is down. First injury of the night. There's no telling how an injured special teams player will affect the roster. Things could get interesting here in terms of who comes on to return punts and kicks for Lopez if he's hurt. Santa Fe could have to call on a star to get back there, and wouldn't that be interesting? First and 10 at the 28-yard line for the Gorillas, and the handoff goes to Montoya, and Montoya picks up a modest 1 yard. Wilson on the tackle.
Number 56, credited with the tackle.
Second down and 9. These two teams are trying to play in what could end up being one of, or if not the lowest scoring game in SFL history. I don't think we've ever had one lower than 7-3. Still a lot of time, but both defenses have been sharp. Montoya takes a handoff and picks up 6 to make the third down just that much more manageable. Bobby Law now 5 tackles and a sack. Kyle Walsh has an update from the SFL studios. What you got, Kyle?
Another cold night in Buffalo. When your offense is struggling, who are you going to call? Who else? Marquis Tool. Tool goes untouched here like a roadrunner against the Coyotes.
Me, me.
Queen City has regained the lead, 20-17 in a tight divisional battle. Oh, how nice. A bow to the tired defenders. Back to you, Cam.
Third and 3.
Yeah, Heechul rubbing it in just a bit there. Third down and three, thanks Kyle, from the 34-yard line. Wilson out of the shotgun. Back to pass, trying to convert. They were just 2 for 8 in the first half, and a beautiful pass down the field for a Santa Fe first down. That's Bosco Law on the tackle. But Juan Bosco has been the secret weapon of the Santa Fe offense tonight. He's been really tough to stop. A slant all the way across the field, and Law beats O'Neal to the stop. First down and 10 at the 47 in Santa Fe. Looking sharp here on the opening drive of the second half. Hand off Montoya right side. That line is sealed. And Montoya stretches ahead for a 6-yard gain. Gatlin making the stand at the Skyhawk 47-yard line. If you're not on the SFL message boards, you're missing out on a great community and great fun. SimulationFL.ProBoards.com or visit SimulationFL.com and go to the community section of the SFL website. We've got weekly pick'em, NFL discussion, SFL discussion, of course, and a whole lot more. That was Brock, no relation to Sebastian Brock, on the stop. Third and one at the 44. Wilson changing the play. Another third down and short here. And outside, the pass is hauled in. That's Nick T. Quick. And Quick's sure hands make the nice play. And Santa Fe continues on the move. Nearly 3 minutes now taken off the third quarter clock on this drive. Approaching scoring position. Spurgeon had a lid on Juan Bosco early and often in this game, but Bosco has started to win the battle. Hand off Montoya up the middle. Got some space, and Montoya picks up a nice 5 yards. Gatlin, another tackle. Billy Joe, that is. Billy Joe and Jeb, military brothers, playing for a team that has a military theme. And the military theme is common across the league. Sioux Falls and Baltimore playing in a game that will honor America next Sunday in the opening, as Wilson throws a wobbler and Quick dropped it. Two hands, son. Just 2 catches on 6 targets. This is a touchdown if Quick doesn't showboat, as he beats, well, the pass was a little bit overthrown, beats Fierro on the double move. Now it's 3rd and 5. Sioux Falls, Baltimore, playing in the Sparrows home opener of Liberty Park. A beautiful project there in Sioux Falls to incorporate Mount Rushmore in the end zone. 3rd down and 5, and that pass is caught just ahead of the sticks to the 29-yard line for a first down. That's the first catch of the night for Chris Bush. 6'1", 250. And that is a huge play. Santa Fe, 2 for 8 in the first half on third down. They are 3 for 3 on this drive. Back to pass, deep shot, Wilson, the pass caught, and a broken tackle! Touchdown, Santa Fe! Finally, the streak over for the Gorillas. Wilson makes the connection, a beautiful pass. And Billy Joe Gatlin went for the pick, was not there to make the play. And Santa Fe takes their first lead of the night. Number 16, number 15 on the hole. And oh, the extra point is blocked. Zeke Klein gets his extra point blocked. and it's 9-7. Wow, that could really come back and haunt Santa Fe. Gorillas kick it away. They're only up two. From the three. And a nice move on the return. They're up to the 25-yard line. And Santa Fe has totaled 9 points, just like they did last week. Brooks on the return, first and 10 of the 25. Carries, 78 yards, most on that big run to end the first half for Johnny English. Three in the backfield for Monroe. Cannon has been really quiet. He's at the top of the screen, and Johnny English loses 3 yards. Another solid stop. Anytime they've run to flank Frank Flores' side, it's been a mess for Johnny English in the offense. Second and 13 at the 22. Split backs for Monroe. And they toss it across the field to English. Great blocking. English is home free. Flores trying to catch him. Johnny English has touchdown number 5. All set up by the blocking. What a phenomenal job by Carolina up front. Look at the block right there, the second, the third. And Johnny English did not have to do much. He's got 5 touchdowns in 7 quarters.
Number 2 is back for the point after. Number 11 on the hold.
Carolina regains the lead on Santa Fe. And instead of the Gorillas being down 4, they are down 5 off the blocked extra point. 14-9. Back-to-back touchdowns to start the third quarter after a very defensive first half. And Santa Fe's lead doesn't last long. Carolina kicks it deep from the 8, and it's Lopez on the return, so Lopez not out for long. Back in time to return Santa Fe's next kickoff. And Matt Wilson's got to be thinking, what do I got to do? I go down and I score a touchdown, and then by the time I get back on the field, I'm losing again. They start from the 28. Carolina shifts their line and linebackers, showing an outside blitz. They bring it. Montoya tried to get outside, and he is lucky to get even 2 yards as Bobby Law and the 253s out there, Brock, combined for the stop. Montoya under 3 yards per carry. Second and 8.
Second and 8. Ball at the 30-yard line.
Receivers either side. Quick caught the touchdown. Bosco's had a solid night. They look for Bosco right over the top. That's a first down and a pickup of 16. Matt Wilson looks a lot more comfortable here in the first half. Taking some chances, but some good ones. Straight back. There's no way Jeb Gatlin's going to get his hands on that. And a drop in the bucket to Juan Bosco. First down and 10 at the 46-yard line. Two receivers and Montoya in the backfield. Wilson back to pass. Wilson fires it left side. Dangerous throw. And Bosco is out of bounds. Coming up Monday night, it's the game of the week. D.C. at Minneapolis as the defending champs try to avoid 0-2. Orlando is at Houston also tomorrow, 7 Central, 8 Eastern, here on the second SFL Network. Second down and 10. I couldn't do a Spanish broadcast if you paid me $3 million to do it, because I don't know it. Hand off to Montoya, and he's got some space. Gatlin had the tackle, but a defensive lineman came in and pushed Montoya about 3 more yards upfield. End up being a 3rd down and 5. Montoya unexpectedly shoved forward. He'll take that.
3rd and 5 from the Demons, 48-yard.
4 receivers. 2 either side of the line. Wilson's got time. Fires middle into double coverage. Caught, first down. Chris Bush's 2nd catch. What Ramos? Is 50 million pesos about, what, $4? I don't know. Got to brush up on my peso logic. 1st and 10 at the 38. Santa Fe on the move again. 4 minutes to go in the third in a tight game. 14-9. Wilson straight back. Flips it out. Bosco. Pass caught. 4-yard gain. D.C. Minneapolis will be quite the game. The Dragons lost to Baltimore 26-23 in an epic one. Minneapolis edged Sioux Falls 38-30 in one of the most offensive-minded games of week one. Back and forth that game went. Montoya takes the handoff on 2nd and 6 and again makes it a manageable 3rd down. Santa Fe has converted every 3rd down in the second half. It is Doug Bose bobblehead night for Minneapolis. And wearing all red tomorrow are the Maulers. DC also wearing alternates tonight, so you'll get a pretty look at some good sets of uniforms out there as Maurice Spurgeon knocked that away from Bosco. It's 4th down. And this will be a 47-yard field goal attempt for Zeke Klein. Has not missed a field goal attempt in his first couple of games, but Carolina just blocked the extra point.
Number 16 will come in to attempt a field goal from the 30-yard line. Number 15 on the hold.
Field goal from 47 yards away for Klein. That's good. 14-12. Temperature is expected in the below zero for Monday night's game. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna need those toe warmers. Been in below temperatures once in Chicago, -1, and you know, at some point it gets to be so cold that it's just cold. From the goal line, good kick by Klein. Carolina on the return. Klein's knocked in 3 field goals tonight. 14-12. Skyhawks holding a slim lead. Dramatic games all over the place tonight on the SFL family of networks.
1st and 10 from the Demons, 21-yard line.
What's going on in NYC? I know Cleveland had the lead there for a while. Monroe swings it out to English, and English has been very quiet in the passing game, loses a yard. Monroe has 83 yards of passing, and Carolina is winning. That is absurd. And most of that 83 yards came in the first quarter. Second down 11. Four receivers, empty set for Monroe. Three-step drop, Monroe gets it away just in time. Pass caught for a five-yard gain. Since Shan Varner caught that long pass down the field, Carolina's biggest pass play of the day, and it's where they've gotten most of their yardage, Varner has been very, very quiet. Hasn't even been targeted by Monroe. Third down and six out of the eye for the Skyhawks. Santa Fe's defense is tightened up here on this drive, and English is trying to stretch it outside. He does and breaks a tackle. Past the 40, English, past midfield. Got a block late. Johnny English in the open field. Touchdown number six, and Carolina's up eight. Again, the blocking from Carolina outstanding on the play. And a made extra point can push it to a two-possession game for the first time tonight. Carlo Montero, a rare missed tackle. And right at the last second, Frank Flores got blocked. And it springs English again. Carolina teaching English tonight in the third quarter.
It's back for the point after. Number 11 on the hold.
And the extra point for Carolina is good. It's a 9-point game.
The extra point is good.
From the 11-yard line, Santa Fe on the return, up to the 29. Three to go. Gorillas down nine. Carolina's offense, Johnny English namely, is woken up here in the third quarter, and Wilson gets plastered into the turf. Bosco targeted again. That's the 15th time already in this game that he's been targeted. And we've got an update from Kyle Walsh. Kyle, what's going on in New York?
Ever since that first possession, NYC has been stuck in the mud. Trying to make a comeback, Peters is picked off by Biomish Keiki in the end zone. The Vipers have built a 10-point lead late. Now, back to the crew in Mexico.
10. Ball at 29-yard.
Wow, what an outstanding start to the season so far for Cleveland as they're trying to hang on in New York City, where the Sailors continuing to struggle. Wilson, deep shot, right side, caught. This game has really opened up in the third quarter. Bosco gets a first down, Santa Fe to midfield. Coming up here on the end of the third quarter, Wilson changing the play on a first down. Straight back, Wilson, all kinds of time. That's rare tonight, but Fierro comes in and knocks it away. Got another update from Kyle Walsh, a bizarre update coming up from the SFL studios in 30 seconds.
Second and 10.
Second down and 10 following the incompletion. It's Fierro's second knockdown tonight. Showing outside blitz, Carolina. They run it straight up the gut. Montoya finds success. It's third down and five. Kyle Walsh back at the SFL studios. What you got for us, Kyle?
Five on the play. Number five.
Controversy in Buffalo as the fans are raging. Garcia and company think they scored a touchdown, but they did not. The SFL postgame explains at the conclusion of the Santa Fe, Carolina, why that was not a touchdown. Corsair settled up 40-24 late. Now let's send it back to Spalding.
52 with the tackle.
A costly mistake potentially there by Daniel Garcia sliding before the end zone. Matt Wilson up to 196 yards, his QBR nearly to 100. Third down and five. Santa Fe down the middle, caught, first down, and pushing Nick T. Quick forward to the 28-yard line. Wow, Matt Wilson in the second half has been really outstanding. Santos got to be thrilled with that in the chat room along with Ramos Lynn. Back and forth here in the third, Santa Fe driving again. Back to pass, and it's caught to the 17. That's Bosco in traffic. Wilson is putting these passes. They are just darts, man. And that is the end of the third quarter. Carolina 21, Santa Fe 12, but the Gorillas are on the move. This is the SFL Network. Skyhawks trying to become the first team in the Gray Conference to go 2-0. I'm your play-by-play commentator, Cameron Irvine, live from Spradling International Field. A beautiful night, dipping into the high 60s. It's not going to be that warm in Minneapolis tomorrow for the Dragons and Maulers. Back to pass, Wilson in trouble, throws off his back foot, and overshot an intended receiver who was diving for the football. Second down and 10 for Santa Fe. Wilson doing a good job again of escaping the pressure. Everyone up close to the line for Carolina. Back to pass. Wilson fires left side. They ruled out of bounds. Wilson looking for Bosco. Now it's third and long. A field goal would cut the deficit to 6.
The home team are challenging. Whether the pass.
And Santa Fe is going to challenge. Let's take a look. Wilson to Bosco. He needs 1 foot. He may have dragged that right foot. That's tough to tell.
After review, the pass has been ruled complete. The catch was made prior to going out of bounds. The home team will not be charged with a timeout. Third down.
So it is a completion. Santa Fe wins the challenge.
Third and two.
Third and three at the 9. And Wilson pump fakes the slant and goes to the end zone. It's incomplete. Knocked away at the last minute. Oh, I thought there for a minute Chris Bush had a touchdown in double coverage. Wilson put that, Matt Wilson that is, in a phenomenal spot. Bush somehow nearly caught that ball, and Santa Fe has to settle for 3.
Number 16, back to attempt a field goal.
So Carolina's defense holds. The Gorillas will try to trim the gap to 6. Big welcome to YCL3P3D for joining us. And we hope you join us every night of SFL action throughout the season. And the chip shot, 26-yard field goal is good. 21-15. Coming up next, the SFL postgame show. We'll have highlights and box scores from around the SFL tonight as we break down who did things right and who didn't in this fifth night of action of season six. The SFL postgame show comes up at the conclusion of Santa Fe, Carolina here on SFLN1. From the 2-yard line, Skyhawks on the return, past the 25 to the 26-yard line. YCL3P3D. You can watch three games at the same time at simulationfl.com if you go to the game day tab, and if it's too big of a strain on your internet connection, you can flip back and forth between the channels every game night on simulationfl.com, exclusively on simulationfl.com. Second and 10, the pass intended for Caesar Cannon. That has been the one very big positive for Santa Fe tonight. They have not let Jamison Monroe do anything in the passing game. Caesar Cannon has been shut out by Frank Flores. Split backs for Monroe on second down and 10, trying to protect the 6-point lead. Monroe back to pass, swings it out right side. A rare completion for Jamison Monroe. 96 yards passing now as Iba completes it. It was all Johnny English in the fourth quarter. The Cleveland Vipers have improved to 2-0. Analysis and highlights of that game coming up on the postgame show. Cleveland plays Queen City, who's locked in a battle with Sioux Falls next week. Johnny English is free again. English being chased by a linebacker inside the 40. Nobody can catch Johnny English. He scores. 7, count them, 7 touchdowns for the league's highest paid player in the first 8 quarters of the season. I can't believe no one was able to catch the big fella. English is not the fastest running back of the bunch, that is for sure. But English doing his thing. He's got 3 touchdowns in the second half. And Santa Fe now down 12. And now will Carolina decide to go for 2? And it appears... Nope, they'll kick the extra point. So Carolina has extended the lead to 28-15. Almost entirely on the ground here in the second half. And Johnny English competing with David Overstreet and Darnell Black at the top for best running backs. The Gray Conference is the running back conference. Overstreet, Black, and English have just had stellar starts to the season. Gray Conference defense is scratching their heads on how to shut these guys down. But with 10:03 to go in the fourth quarter, Carolina is that far away from starting the season 2-0. They play Oklahoma City next week. Back to pass. Wilson to the sideline, and the feet were out of bounds. Quick has really struggled tonight. 10 targets, just 4 catches. Second and 10 for the Gorillas. They've been trailing the entire night. Briefly held the lead 9-7, but then the extra point was blocked by Carolina. Second down and 10 at the 30. Wilson straight back to pass down the middle. Oh, beautiful catch! Nick T quick, laying it out for his teammates. Clock ticking, but still time for Wilson and company. Wilson is ripped. Man, did you see that? I wish I was ripped like that. First and 10 of the 43, Wilson deep, drop back, fires short, and Fierro all over it. 4-yard pickup. SFL Maulers, I don't believe so. I don't think they've ever started 2-0 in franchise history, but we'll have to check that postgame. 9 minutes left to second and 6. Santa Fe down 28-15 in the Sunday spotlight game. They hand it off to Montoya, and Montoya picks up a few, 3rd and 3. 9 tackles now for Bobby Law tonight. Clock still rolling. Santa Fe down 13. Shotgun for Wilson. Back to pass. Wilson fires middle. Incomplete. Knocked out of the hands of Bosco. O'Neal lays a big hit. And there's still 8 minutes left. I think Santa Fe would be wise to just punt it away, and that's what they're going to do. But what a hit by Julius O'Neal in the middle of the field. Carolina just continues to make big plays.
Oh yeah, punter, I'm coming, I'm blocking this.
From the 12 to the 18. .20 to go. Santa Fe, they've got to sell out on Johnny English. They've just got to figure out how to contain him. He's the only piece to this offense that's done anything all night. Out of the eye, Monroe hands it off English, and English stiff arms one defender, and Alvarado saved a big play. A pickup of 5. English, 298 tonight. He's the first back in week 2 to get over 200 yards. Only one other running back has over 200, and that was Darnell Black's insane performance in week 1 against Louisville. Second down and 5 at the 23. Handoff English around the left side. Good blocking again. First down of the 32, and Johnny English is over 300 yards. And this is the this has been the Achilles heel of Santa Fe. Look at the blocking. I mean, it's just been fantastic. Santa Fe's Achilles is not having the people in the front, in the teeth of that defense to stop those runs, and it has really bit them in the last couple of weeks. They've been great against the pass. They've really struggled against the run. Off the hands of the intended receiver, and it should have been picked off. Can't believe Santa Fe did not get their hands on that loose ball, and it's 2nd and 10. The clock stops with 7:23 to go. 2nd and 10. English on the sideline for the second straight play. Empty set, 4 wide, trying to get Monroe over 100 yards. 5 in the box for Santa Fe. They rush 4. Deep ball, Monroe picked off! He overthrew his intended receiver! Right into the hands of Christoph Montero. And the Montero brothers have two picks. New life for Santa Fe with 7:18 to go in the fourth. Jason 1347, don't worry, we got the post-game show coming up on the SFL Network. Stay tuned. Wilson, deep shot, caught by Busco, breaks a tackle, touchdown, Santa Fe! Get a load of that! Twenty-eight, 21 with 7:10 to go in the ball game. It was 7-3 at the half. Extra point for Klein. Has already had one block tonight. Good. And Matt Wilson has two touchdowns and no interceptions tonight. A very good night for Wilson in his home debut. Still plenty of time left in this one. Santa Fe's defense needs to step up big. From the goal line, Skyhawks on the return for the 22. Coming up later this week on the SFL Network, Queen City, Cleveland on Thursday. The 2-0 Vipers home opener. Carolina also at Oklahoma City. Sunday at noon, Baltimore at Sioux Falls. It's the SFL Game of the Week next week. Houston at Santa Fe, San Francisco at DC as well. That's coming up later this week after Monday's epic DC Minneapolis matchup here on the SFL Network. Johnny English takes a toss left side, and English picks up 8 Montero on the tackle. Carlo, that is, his first tackle all night.
7 on the play. Number 9 with the tackle.
Let's go!
Second and 2.
Ball at the 30 for Carolina. English over 300 yards rushing on the night, but Monroe has really struggled to get his weapons in the pass game involved. Out of the eye, Monroe changing the play. 10 on the play clock. Monroe will hand it off to English. He's stuffed in the backfield. A 5. Count it, 5-yard loss. Carlo Montero back-to-back tackles. Man, talk about making an impact. No tackles in the first 3.5 quarters. And back-to-back big plays for Montero forces a 3rd down and 7.
Third and 6 from the Demons, 26 yards.
Six minutes to go in the fourth. Monroe, sidearm, throw it! Oh, it's almost picked off and taken to the house! Montero again, 4th down. Oh my goodness, that would have given him the lead. Carolina's one-dimensional offense starting to bite them here late in this game. High snap, Carolina nearly put that one in the end zone. With a deep kick to the 38, Santa Fe on the return, nice one up to the 44, 5:49 remains. First and 10 at the 44 for Santa Fe, trying to erase a 13-point fourth quarter deficit. Hand off Montoya, and Bobby Law jumps all over him. Just 60 yards on 20 carries for Montoya, but he's been a good change of pace back, and that's actually Brock on the tackle. Two teams have some duplicate numbers out there. We'll clean that up in week three. Second and nine at the 45. Two receivers, both to the top of the screen. Wilson back to pass, and Wilson dumps it off short for a three-yard gain. That's Ulysses Mora, who's been really quiet tonight. Third and six. The other two games in the books tonight, waiting on the conclusion of Carolina-Santa Fe, the SFL postgame show, brought to you by the SFL Update, comes your way at the conclusion of this game. Wilson to throw, deep ball, it is caught again into the 23-yard line. Nick T. Quick, first down, Santa Fe. Matt Wilson has really found a rhythm here in the second half. Four and a half to go. Hand off Montoya around the left side. Montoya, nice run. Four-yard pickup. O'Neal on the tackle. What a fantastic game. We had a 31-23 thriller on Thursday night. We got another great one here, and the game of the week is tomorrow. Hand off Montoya again, but dropped the line of scrimmage. English, ridiculous numbers tonight. Santa Fe has just not been in the right spots, but really it's been more about the blocking for Carolina tonight. And it has been any skill from English. Boys up front have done a great job. It's third and six, Carolina trying to protect their lead and a 2-0 start to the season with Oklahoma City next week. Back to pass, Wilson fires right side. Oh, he overshot a wide open receiver. Goodness gracious. Matt Wilson's had a nice night, but he really screwed the pooch on that one. Klein will come out to attempt a field goal, but that is a huge deflator for Santa Fe. All sorts of momentum. And Wilson overshoots his target. Field goal from 36 yards away. Good from Klein. Klein has four field goals tonight. He's got seven on the season, a perfect 7 for 7. What an investment Klein has been to this organization. Santa Fe is going to onside kick. We've seen crazier things, but Santa Fe not wasting any time. Onside kick is caught by Carolina, and they're still in the move. Oh, almost scored. And now it's up to the Gorilla defense to play some ball. Hernandez saved the touchdown. First and 10. So Santa Fe goes for the onside kick, probably a little too early. And if they can't get a stop on Johnny English, they could be in some trouble. Monroe hands off to English, and he's stopped in the backfield, a three-yard loss. Clock rolling, three timeouts. I guess Santa Fe figures as long as we hold them to a field goal, we still have a shot at a touchdown. But if we recover the onside kick, then we have a chance to just go out and win or tie the game. But at the same time, your defense, I mean, they have struggled a bit tonight against Johnny English, so maybe that went into the categorizing of the decision-making, but it's third and 14 now. Johnny English is getting bottled up. Powers on the tackle. Carolina is outside of field goal range, and on third down and 14, they have done nothing in the passing game. This is some really dangerous territory here for the Skyhawks. High formation, Monroe changing the call, third down and 14. Does he dare try to throw it? Hand off to English, and English is tackled in the backfield. Carolina has to punt. We've hit the two-minute warning. This is the SFL Network. Fourth down and 15. I'm your play-by-play commentator, Cameron Irvine. Johnson has to punt it away. Santa Fe's home opener. We're in the alt oranges tonight. It has been a thrilling night across the SFL family of networks and a thrilling week overall. Carolina trying to pin Santa Fe inside the 10, and the ball will bounce to the 4, and they stop it at the 5. What a kick for Carolina. Santa Fe is going to have to go 95 yards for the win, about 65 for the tie.
First and 10 from 5 yards.
Can Matt Wilson make everyone forget all about Daniel Garcia? Straight drop back, back to pass middle. Oh, what a catch to the 15-yard line! And Quick gets up to talk some smack, but he's got to get set. Nick T. Quick was running his mouth, and it takes him forever to get back to the line of scrimmage. Wilson, back to pass right side, caught again to the 28-yard line. No huddle and all three timeouts for Santa Fe. Wilson looking around, swings it out to Montoya. That's only a 1 yard gain. The clock is running. That's been the one chink in the armor for Santa Fe. Throwing that pass in the flat, it hasn't worked out. Deep shot, Wilson wide open. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Quick, touchdown, come back. More possible than ever. Nobody on him. But it left Carolina, 56 seconds left. The problem, though, for the Skyhawks is they haven't completed a ball downfield except that one pass to Shan Varner all night. And Matt Wilson has been outstanding in his home debut. Santa Fe was down. ...28-15 and has scored 17 straight. The Gorillas kick it away. Oh man, Carolina almost didn't catch the kickoff and returns it up to the 23-yard line. The Skyhawks are having a meltdown here on the road. Good point by Jason 1347. Almost eerie, although DC's got much better weapons in the passing game than Carolina. Empty set. Jamison Monroe hasn't done squat all night. Back to pass, dump off, 5 yard pickup. That's just not gonna get it done. Down to 40 seconds, Carolina's got all three timeouts. Monroe, deep shot, wide open! Cesar Cannon past the 40 out of the 39! Timeout, Skyhawks! How? How do you let Cannon, who's been in a bubble all night long, burst? Frank Flores, just let him go! And Christoph Montero saved a score. Two timeouts, 32 seconds. Carolina needs a touchdown. Monroe, empty set again. This isn't about English. This is about Monroe. Back to pass. Dumps it off. Oh my goodness. Cannon went the wrong way. I've seen it all. What in the world is Cannon doing? Full blown. Oh my goodness. Beep, beep, beep. Second and 16. Carolina down four. Monroe back to pass, throws it over the middle. Forner, he's going the wrong way! Good night! I have never seen anything like it. Twice they tried to reverse field. Oh my goodness. You gotta be kidding me. Third and 16. Carolina cannot figure out how to go forward. Monroe back to pass against a blitz. Throws down the middle. Perfect pass to the 30-yard line. There's only 12 seconds left. Carolina has to hurry up. They cannot spike it. It's fourth and one. Down to 7 seconds to go. Monroe, 5 seconds to go. Back to pass. Monroe, everyone's running short routes. And they're held out of the end zone. And that's the end of the ball game. Santa Fe wins. And the post-game report is next. What a night. Carolina loses to Santa Fe 32-28. Welcome to the postgame show. Let's take a look at the final numbers. Jameson Monroe just 16-25, 154 yards and two picks. Johnny English was the hero, but in crunch time, Carolina needed a passing game, and they didn't have one. 25 carries, 305 yards, four touchdowns. Bobby Law, another tremendous night. 12 tackles, one sack. Matt Wilson, outstanding. 33 of 49, 423 yards, three touchdowns. He did not throw an interception. Nick T. Quick with the game winner. Eight catches, 193 yards, and two touchdowns. And Carlo Montero, nine tackles, two passes, defender, one interception. We still do not have an undefeated team in the Gray Conference. Let's take a look at what else happened around the league tonight. NYC tonight, and the Sailors off to a strong start. Carter Peters gets on the board. Steven Olenek, beautiful D-I-V-E touchdown. 7-0 Sailors. But two plays later, check this out. Trey Jackson, the big fella, how does he get so open behind the entire NYC defense? Breaks a tackle to 25, and Cleveland says, hey, Sailors, take that. We're all tied up at 7, middle of the first quarter. Trey Jackson proving to be a huge factor for this Viper offense. 10-10 just before the half. Caleb Wright, who had a career-high quarterback rating in this game. Beautiful pass to Scott King. The defender falls over, and the King is off to the races and gives Cleveland a 7-point halftime advantage. Late in this one, Carter Peters trying to get a comeback started. Oyama Shigeki thwarts him, and the Vipers are 2-0. So Cleveland is now 2-0. They beat the Sailors 20-10 to drop the NYC Sailors to 0-2. Cleveland joins Baltimore at the top of the Gray Conference. The Teal Conference does not have anyone undefeated. The Gray Conference has Baltimore and Cleveland now. Caleb Wright, 20 of 25, 301 yards, two touchdowns, no picks. It was a career-high QB rating for Wright, 143.5, nearly perfect. Scott King and the tight end, Trey Jackson, combined for 10 catches, 234 yards, and two touchdowns. For NYC, Carter Peters, another struggling night, 28 of 41, 243 yards, one touchdown, and three picks. Sultan Muhammad, 11 catches for 92 yards, but didn't really get a clear shot in the open field. The Cleveland Viper defense has allowed just 490 yards of total offense in two games, and the 2-0 Vipers host the 1-1 Queen City Corsairs in Cleveland's home opener of their new stadium Thursday. Falls in Queen City. This was crazy. We pick it up in the third quarter, and Parkeet Chol is opening this game up. Queen City at one time down 17-3. They've come back and taken the lead in the middle of the third, 20-17. It was Parkeet Chol's second long touchdown run of the game, and Sioux Falls a bit stunned. Queen City up 27-24. Daniel Garcia slides, and that's not a touchdown? You gotta be kidding me. We're about to break it down. Queen City had to settle for a field goal, which meant they were only up by six. 30-24 with 5 minutes left. Now 1:35 to go. Sioux Falls down six, and Tyree hits Cadilla for a touchdown, and Sioux Falls takes the lead with 90 seconds to go. Last chance for Daniel Garcia. Fires down the middle. Sioux Falls corrals him, and the Sparrows get the win. So Sioux Falls in a dramatic games win, 31-30. So we actually looked up that quarterback slide in post game, and Daniel Garcia was marked down at the start of his slide, which was in fact outside of the end zone, and it costs Queen City the game. Now think about this. Daniel Garcia on a team that loses late 31-30. Where have you seen that narrative develop before? Julius Tyree, 31 of 40, 275 yards, two touchdowns, was picked off twice. Anderson, 25, 121 and two, but mostly contained. Zen Osika, five tackles, five passes defended, two of them picks. He was on fire. Queen City's Daniel Garcia, rough night. 24 of 34, 297 yards, four touchdowns. Parkeet Chole scored three more touchdowns tonight. Johnny English has seven. Parkeet Chole has six early on in the season. 16 carries, 188 yards, three touchdowns. DJ McCoo and the rookie Aquantis Shine have 12 tackles each, a pass defended, and three tackles for loss to lead the Queen City defense. Corsairs fall to 1-1. Sioux Falls 1-1. And as we take a look at what's coming up in the next 3 days here on the SFL Network, Monday night, D.C. at Minneapolis, Orlando and Houston is on SFLN 2, game of the week in frigid Minnesota. Thursday, Queen City and Cleveland along with Carolina, Oklahoma City, so a pair of 1-1 teams in that second game, and we'll see if Johnny English or Pete Bruschi can bounce back. Sunday, noon Central, 1 p.m. Eastern before the NFL's conference championship doubleheader. Baltimore at Sioux Falls is the game of the week. Houston at Santa Fe, San Francisco at D.C. It was a wild night. Don't forget that the box scores will be up in the next couple of hours on the league website in the stats category. We'll get everything all fixed up. Santa Fe scores the final. Well, math escapes. Final 17 points of this game to win 32-28. It's been a long night. A crazy night. 17 straight for Santa Fe in the final 10 minutes of this one. It may just be the largest fourth quarter comeback in league history, down 13. Although, if I remember correctly, Orlando had a game slip away from them last year. We'll have to look up all the records, get all the facts for you as we move on through the season. D.C., Minneapolis, tomorrow, Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Celebrate it with us in a fantastic game from Minnesota. This has been a presentation of the Simulation Football League and the SFL Network. I'm the play-by-play commentator and commissioner of the SFL, Cameron Irvine. Santa Fe 32, Carolina 28. Catch your breath. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night, everybody.